In this video, we are going to create a COVID cases tracker. We are going to use a CSV file, which is created by Johns Hopkins University, which is updated on a daily basis. This file contains the cases as on that date across the world for each country. Usually we import the data in Power BI using Power BI Desktop and then publish the report onto Power BI Web. Now I'm going to do it differently. On Power BI website itself, there is an equivalent of data import and cleanup, which is Power Query. That is called a data flow. So I have a new workspace on the Power BI Web. I'm going to create a new data flow. Let's add a new entity. It shows you all the data sources like the Get Data dialog on Power BI Desktop. Our data is a CSV file. This URL is available in the description. In the next step, it'll open the web version of Power Query. We now need to clean up this data, get it ready, and then create the dashboard in Power BI Desktop. So now let's transform the data. Transform means cleanup. So first thing is to get rid of unwanted columns. I don't need this column. I also don't need lat long because we already have the country names. So right click on those columns and say remove columns. The first row is actually the header, so let's set that by using this option. Look at the data and check, is it good data or bad data? If you have not seen my video about good or bad data, I strongly recommend you see the video of 10 rules for good data. One of the rules is each data column must have a header. We do have headers here, but these are not really headers, they're data. Ideally, we just need three columns, country, date, and number. In order to do that, we have to use something called unpivot, or it's like a bulk transpose operation. So we select the good column, right click on it, and choose unpivot other columns. Now, while we are doing this, we have to also remember this file is going to be refreshed every day. So there is one important thing to note. Go to the source. Look at the formula, expand it from here. You'll notice that it is selecting 136 columns because as of now, there are those many columns. Tomorrow, one more column will be added, but if you refresh, that column will not be picked up. So to avoid that from happening, we remove this hard-coded column's number along with the comma. Now let's come to the current last step. The unpivot operation is done. And we just need to rename these columns. So I'll call this C date. And these are number of cases. The next step is to look at the data type. This is text. We need to convert it to date. But don't just convert it to date. It's a good idea to use the locale. It's in month, day, year format. So we choose the data type as date and then open this drop down. This has a lot of entries. These are languages followed by countries. So we are looking for English, United States. Now it is MDY. That is correct. The data type is now correctly set. So text, date, number. That's all we need to do in order to clean up this data. So let's save and close this. So this data flow I am saving as COVIDJH. One small thing we need to do is instead of calling this table a query, let's give it a name. That is done by going to edit query. The same query. I should have done it earlier, but never mind. Just double click on the query name and I'll call it CD, COVID data. We can say refresh now and then come back to our COVID tracker workspace. This is the data flow we just created. Now we need to make sure this gets refreshed every day. So click on the three dots, settings. We can schedule the refresh. You have to enable it first, choose the frequency, then the time zone, and then the exact time. I'm going to choose it at 1 a.m. Now the data set is ready and it's getting automatically refreshed on a daily basis. Now it is time to import it in Power BI and then create the dashboard. So in Power BI, we go to get data, but we are not going to choose the data source as CSV because the import and cleanup has already been done. We choose Power Platform as the source. We want data flow. All the workspaces containing data flows will be shown here. So this is the one we just created. This is the workspace. This is the data flow. And this is the entity or table. There's nothing to clean, so we will not choose transform. Simply load it. Once it is imported in Power BI, few things to be done here. We need to specify that this is a country. That means it should be treated like a country. In fact, I don't want the full name like that. Let me change it to just country. This should also have been done in the data flow, but never mind. We have a column tools tab in which there are data categories, and this has to be labeled as a country, not county. Remember, country. This will help Power BI understand to treat it like a geographical location rather than just text. The date format, I don't want to show the year. Hopefully it will not be there after December. So I'm just going to say DD MMM. Now we are ready to create the dashboard. It may look simple, but it is not that simple. First of all, let's try to show all the countries and the number of cases they have. That should be easy. Let's see. So I'm going to choose a simple bar chart. In that, we will put country on the axis and cases on the values. I'll put data labels so that we understand what is happening. Now you'll notice that whatever it is showing is completely wrong. It's showing 68 million cases. No, that's wrong. What is really happening? It is actually taking the sum of all the cases across all the dates, and that's why cases are getting repeated. That's why the number is artificially inflated. What we really need to do is to only show the data as of today or as of the maximum date available in the data set. So first step, let's find the last date because this is going to get refreshed on a daily basis. That is done by creating a new measure. So I'll call it max date. Now, when you are editing this is a very small font. It's a good idea to expand this and use control key on the keyboard with mouse wheel so that we can expand it a little. I want to find the last date in the data. In which data? CD is our table name and C date is the column. So that gives us max date. Press enter. And if there is any error, it is going to show it to you. The problem in Power BI is we can't see what is the current value of that max date, and that is usually required for debugging or troubleshooting. So the simplest way to do that is to add a card, not one card, because card takes only one number. We want multiple numbers. Click on multi-row card and I will put max date on top of it. This way we can keep on noticing what is happening to the calculations or measures we are creating. Now this also should look like our date. So click on max date. It gets measure tools. And here also we'll put it as DDMMM. Now we want to use this kind of max date and find out what are the cases as of that date. That's another measure. So let's call that measure latest cases. New measure. Again, that formula bar will open, expand it. That's a good idea. And we'll name it latest cases. Here I want to keep the value of max date in a temporary variable and then use it in a calculate function. So that is done by defining a variable. In the next line, I want to calculate. So we put a return command. And whatever comes after return is in brackets like this. So just complete the bracket and then we write the actual thing here. We can use tabs also for easier understanding. So essentially we are going to use a calculate function. Calculate. What are we going to calculate? Sum of cases. CD cases. But with a filter condition where the date matches the temp or max date. The date is same as temp, and that should do it. Now just to check what happened, we will also make sure we go to our multi-row card and add this measure as well. So that is the correct number. As of 1st June, it was 6.2 million. In this case, I want to use not the cases measure, but the latest cases. So here I'm going to remove the values and put latest cases here. So now this is correct. I also want to show this whole data as it is. And I want to mention what was the current date on which this data is being shown. So I'm going to use another card, new multi-row card. Here we'll put max date and latest cases. I'll just increase the font size a little. Now when it comes to data labels, it is showing it like that, and we are okay with that. But I also want to show that this latest cases should be formatted with a comma so that it becomes easier for people to recognize what is happening. So far we have shown the overall picture. Of course, there's a long scroll bar because there are a lot of countries. Now what I want to do is, this is the overall picture as on this date, but I also want to show what happens across time, because this progressed from 0 to 6 million as of today. So let's do that by having something based on date. So let's create a simple line chart. In that, on the axis we will put date. Once you put anything as date, it gets automatically grouped by year, quarter, month, which we don't want. Open this drop down and just say show me the actual date. Right now nothing is shown. We have to put a value there. In this case we want to see date wise cases, so we will put cases. So this is how the overall thing progressed across time, across countries as well. So I want to show countries here. I want to put countries as legend. The moment you do that, a lot of things happen and you think it is showing the correct data, but it is not. Whenever you get this eye kind of icon there, that means it is only showing significant data points. In basic simple terms, it means there are too many data points to be plotted. It's not able to do it. Now you will notice that this is US, highest number of cases. You would have expected this one to be US, but this is Brazil, so it's all confused. The way to do that, instead of showing all the countries, let's focus on top 20. And that is done by going to filter. Filter area, country, not basic filtering, but top N is what we want. Top 20, let's take. Now top 20 based on what? Of course, we need to give some value here, and that is number of cases. Now when you choose apply filter, the I goes away. That means it is actually plotting it the correct way. And now the highest here will be the correct value. So if I click on the green one, notice this is US. And because this is a line chart, it is actually showing me everything like this. Although this is good, it is difficult to understand which country progressed how, because there are a lot of lines. So let's try a stacked bar chart instead of a line chart. So choose the visualization and change it to stacked bar chart. This is giving a better picture of how each country progressed. Originally, notice this was only China, and now it has gone down and many other countries have taken over. This is a much better way of understanding how the progress happened. But there is one more issue. Notice that China was the highest in the early days, and now it is somewhere 8th or 9th or 10th, whatever. So as time goes by, the ranking between countries is also changing, but we are not able to see that very clearly here. So instead of just having a stacked bar chart, it's a much better idea to use a special type of chart called a ribbon chart. It may look confusing initially. Let me change the colors so that it is easier to understand. You change color scheme from view tab. So now we are able to understand individual color by country. This legend I want more prominent, So I'm going to go to settings and put the legend on the right side. And increase the font size also a little. Now we don't need this debugging multicard, so I'm going to delete it and give this chart more space. The important thing to understand here is it's showing that initially it was only China, then China went down, 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 and now it is at a much, much lower position. This was not at all visible correctly in the line chart or the stack bar chart. The important thing to understand and learn here is that a ribbon chart is better than a stack bar chart because it shows you ranking. So if I go in the early part, obviously China's rank is 1. But now if I go somewhere else, and because I am on the US part of the chart, it's showing you the rank remained the same on previous and next day. And similarly, if I go to a transition period, notice on 9th May, Italy was 3, now it went down to 4. So that is how progression is better understood using ribbon chart. Now question is, can we enhance it a little further? The idea is this particular data is being shown from Jan all the way up to the current date. Can we have a filter which allows us to change the dates and look at smaller portions of period or time? That is done by putting a date slicer. Add a new slicer. Let's put C date on top of it. This is always a dangerous thing to do. Never drag drop. Always drag drop in the field area so that there is no confusion. And move this guy here. So this shows a slider. There are multiple types of sliders. We can say between, before, after. So in our case, I definitely want between. So there's a start date and the end date. And I should be able to move it. The idea is when I move it, it's going to filter this data. It's not going to filter this because here we are using total cases on the current date. So that part is not going to change. This is also not going to change. But this chart will change based on the filter. And now we can understand this much better. One more thing is this is cross filtered. So if I want to see in this whole junk, how is, let's say, Italy doing or India doing? I can click there and this will nicely highlight it. I can also choose multiple countries to check how things are working across time. One thing you may be wondering as to why I did not use a map. The problem is, look at the numbers. America is 1.8 million and New Zealand is 1,500. This is not proportionate at all and it misleads you. There is no map in the world which is going to be able to show you true proportion between million and thousand. That's the reason I did not use a map. Finally, of course, you go to publish and publish it on the Power BI website. We will use the COVID tracker workspace for publishing it. So now in our workspace on the browser, our Power BI website, we have the data flow, the report and the data set. Let's look at the report and finally see how this can be shared with the world. So you go to COVID final. This is our report. Finally, we want to create a link so that people in the world can see this in a read only manner. That is done by going to edit. In the file menu, we have publish to web for public access. You have to create an embed code. This is the embed code. This embed code I will post in the description. And that's it. So this is how we start from scratch and create a useful, functionally beneficial dashboard very quickly using Power BI. So that's it for now. Thank you.